मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर. फर्स्ट लेट अस कैलकुलेट द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ ए हॉलो सिलेंडर अबाउट सेंट्रल एक्सिस. दिस इज अ हॉलो सिलेंडर. द इंटरनल डायमीटर रेडियस ऑफ द सिलेंडर इज स्मॉल आर एंड द एक्सटर्नल रेडियस ऑफ द सिलेंडर इज कैपिटल आर एंड दिस इज द एक्सिस. यू मे से द सेंट्रल एक्सिस ऑफ दिस हॉलो सिलेंडर. सपोज मास ऑफ द सिलेंडर हॉलो सिलेंडर इज एम. एक्सटर्नल रेडियस कैपिटल आर, इंटरनल रेडियस स्मॉल आर. ए हॉलो सिलेंडर कैन बी कंसीडर्ड एज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थिन एनुलर डिस्क और थिन और थिक एनुलर डिस्क. सो आइदर यू कंसीडर दिस हॉलो सिलेंडर एज ए थिक एनुलर डिस्क और यू मे कंसीडर थिन एनुलर डिस्क कॉम्बिनेशन और कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थिन एनुलर डिस्क. We know that the moment of inertia of an annular disc or ring is given by I equal to m by 2 r square plus r square. Thus, the moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the central axis will be also equal to m by 2 r square plus r square. That is external diameter square, radius square, plus the internal radius square. Now let us discuss the moment of inertia of a hollow cylinder about the central diameter. You see, this is the central diameter of the hollow cylinder. Suppose the mass of the hollow cylinder is m, external radius is capital R, internal radius small r, and you consider a thin annular disk. You see, this is a thin annular disk and thickness of this annular disk, let us say, equal to dx. And the annular disk is considered at a distance x from this central diameter. You see, from the central diameter, we have considered a annular disk having thickness dx. Here also you have the external radius capital R and the internal radius small r. And this annular disk is at a distance x from this central diameter. The surface area of the annular disk will be equal to pi r square minus pi r square. Pi, or you may write pi into r square minus r square, because surface area is given by the formula pi r square. So outer surface area minus inner surface area, if you calculate, if you take the difference, then you can find out the surface area of the annular disk. Then what will be the volume? If you multiply the surface area with the thickness, then you will find out the volume. So volume of the annular disk will be equal to pi into r square minus r square into dx. And what suppose the mass of the hollow cylinder we have taken m. So volume of the hollow cylinder will be equal to pi into r square minus r square into l, because this is the surface area of the hollow cylinder multiplied by the length of the cylinder, you will get the volume of the hollow cylinder. Then what will be the mass per unit volume? Since the mass of the cylinder is m and volume of the cylinder is pi into r square minus r square into l, so mass per unit volume will be equal to m divided by pi into r square minus l square into l. So what will be the mass of the annular disk? Because mass of the we have calculated the volume of the annular disk is pi into r square minus r square into dx, and mass per unit volume is equal to this much. So mass of the annular disk will be equal to a mass per unit volume multiplied by the mass of the annular disk, so that you will get the mass of the annular disk. So it will be equal to m by l into dx. So what will be the moment of inertia of the annular disk about the diameter? We want to calculate first the moment of inertia of the annular disk about its diameter. You see in this figure, we have calculated the mass of the annular disk, and this is the diameter of the annular disk, AB. You see, this is the diameter of the annular disk. So you can calculate the moment of inertia of this annular disk about this diameter AB. And we know the moment of inertia of annular disk about diameter is equal to If you write I d, moment of inertia about the diameter, that is equal to m by 4 into r square plus r square. So here you have calculated mass is equal to m by l dx and m by l into dx and r square plus r square. You see, this is this will be same r square plus r square. So m divided by 4 into r square plus r square. So moment of inertia of the annular disc about its diameter AB is equal to m by l dx. This is mass m by 4. You see m by 4 into r square plus r square. So we have calculated the moment of inertia about this diameter. That means this is the moment of inertia about the center of mass. This is the moment of inertia about the center of mass, and this is a parallel axis. So applying parallel axis theorem, moment of inertia of the annular disc about y dash can be calculated by using the parallel axis theorem. That is I equal to id I cm plus m into d square or m into x square. Here d, the distance between the two parallel axes, is equal to x. So m into x square, we can find out the moment of inertia about this axis, that is y dash, that is the central diameter. So applying parallel axis theorem, moment of inertia of the annular disc about y dash will be equal to moment of inertia about the center of mass, that is about the diameter AB, m by l dx r square plus r square divided by 4, we have calculated it, plus mass into x square. Mass of the disc is m by l into dx into distance between the two parallel axes x, so multiply with x square. So moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about y dash can be found out by integrating this above equation from 0 to L by 2. And here we have to multiply 2, because we have to integrate from 0 to L by 2 this side and also from 0 to L by 2 this side. That is why in integration we have to multiply 2. So the moment of inertia will be equal to I integration from 0 to L by 2, then this equation m by L, here 4, so you write here 4L, m into r square plus r square into dx plus m by L into x square dx. Now if you take m by L common, here you have m by L, here you have also m by L, you take m by L common, so in the bracket you have r square divided by 4 into x, because the integration of dx is x. And here the integration of x is q, that is equal to x square, dx is x is q divided by 3. So the value of integration from 0 to L by 2. And if you put the limits of integration and solve it, then you can find, we will find out I will be equal to m into r square divided by 4 plus L square divided by 2L. Which gives the expression for moment of inertia of a hollow cylinder about central diameter. Now let us find out the moment of inertia of a hollow cylinder about end diameter. You see, this is the end diameter and this is your central diameter. We have calculated the moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the central diameter, this diameter, that is equal to m into r square divided by 4 plus l square divided by 12. So this axis and this axis, they are two parallel axes, and the distance between the two parallel axes is L by 2. So using parallel axis theorem, moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the end diameter can be calculated. And this is the moment of inertia about the center of mass, that is about the central diameter, plus the mass of the cylinder into the distance, square of the distance between the two parallel axes, that is L by 2 square. So if you solve it, then you will find out that the moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the end diameter will be equal to m into r square plus r square divided by 4 plus L square by 3.